Ever found yourself skipping breakfast and thinking, am I just torturing myself, or is something cool happening inside my body? Fasting might seem like you're just enduring a rumbling stomach, but there's actually a lot going on under the surface. Your body doesn't just sit idly. It goes through some pretty fascinating metabolic changes. It shifts from relying on carbs to using fat, and sometimes even delivers some surprising health benefits. What you might think is just you suffering through hunger pangs is actually your body working smarter. So let's break down what happens as you fast and why your body is smarter than you think. Spoiler: there's a lot more going on than meets the eye. Fed state, the immediate aftermath of eating. Right after you polish off that last bite of your meal, your body swings into the fed state. Imagine it like an all-hands-on-deck situation. Your digestive system is working hard, breaking down food, and your blood sugar spikes as a result. Enter insulin, the hormone that acts like a VIP delivery guy. Its job is to take that sugar from your bloodstream and either give it to your cells for immediate energy or store it in your liver and muscles as glycogen. The more you eat, especially those hearty, carb-heavy meals, the longer your body stays in this state, cleaning up after your feast. It's like a factory working overtime, turning all that fuel into usable energy and storage for later. During this time, hunger hormones take a backseat. Ghrelin, the pesky hormone that makes you crave food, goes on a coffee break, while leptin, the hormone that tells you you're full, clocks in. It's like your body's way of saying, relax, we're good for now. This is why you feel satisfied after a big meal, even though the satisfaction doesn't last forever. But, spoiler alert, this won't last forever. Eventually, all that food gets processed, and your body is ready for what comes next. As soon as your digestive system finishes its work, the shift begins. The fed state usually lasts anywhere from 3 to 6 hours, depending on the size and content of the meal. The bigger and more carb-heavy your meal, the longer your body spends processing it. Your body uses this time to restore energy levels, repair tissues, and get nutrients to where they're needed. It's a bit like filling up the tank at a gas station before you head out for a long drive. Plus, during this time, any excess calories that aren't used for immediate energy are stored as fat, which your body will later rely on when fasting kicks in. Early fasting state, the calm before the fat-burning storm. About 3 to 4 hours after your last meal, you enter the early fasting state. No more new food is coming in, so your insulin and blood sugar levels start to drop. Now, your body begins dipping into its glycogen stores for energy. Think of it like grabbing leftovers from the fridge. You're still in relatively comfortable territory here, relying on energy you've already stored. Your body is sort of in a waiting mode, seeing if food will come soon. It's not in full fat-burning mode yet, but it's preparing for that shift, like a runner doing stretches before a marathon. This phase is your body's way of easing into fasting, like warming up before a workout. Lipolysis, the breakdown of fat cells, starts to stir in the background, but it's not the main event just yet. You might feel totally fine during this period, especially if you fasted before, but if you're a newbie, this is when you could start feeling a little sluggish or that first pang of hunger. The drop in blood sugar may cause your energy to dip, and you might feel a little hangry. But hold on tight, this is just the beginning. Your body is adjusting to the fact that food isn't coming anytime soon, so it's preparing itself for the next fuel source. This early fasting state lasts until about 12 hours after your last meal, and during this time, your body is transitioning from using glucose to preparing for a shift toward fat as its primary energy source. It's like your body slowly realizing, hey, we might not be getting food soon, better start looking for alternative fuel. It's during this time that you might also notice a slight dip in energy, but nothing too dramatic yet. Your body is still figuring out how long you're planning on withholding food. If you exercise during this state, your body will still rely mostly on glycogen for energy, so fat burning is still minimal. However, exercising while fasting may help you transition into fat burning a little faster because it depletes glycogen stores more quickly. Just make sure you're hydrated and listen to your body's limits as you won't have as much immediate energy. Fasting state, the fat burning bonanza. Now, fast forward to about 18 hours in. At this point, your body has torched through its glycogen stores and has officially switched to burning fat for energy. Welcome to the fasting state. Ketosis, the fancy term for this fat-burning process, kicks into high gear. Your body starts converting fat into ketones, which act as your new energy source. It's like running out of gas and deciding to ride a bike instead. It gets you where you need to go, just with a different kind of fuel. This is when fat reserves, especially those stubborn areas, start getting tapped into. Here's the fun part. Ketones not only provide energy, but can also help suppress your appetite, making fasting a little easier as you go. You might even notice that your breath takes on a slightly fruity scent. Don't panic, it's just a sign you're in ketosis. This is when the magic happens for weight loss and some other potential health perks, like improved focus or even anti-inflammatory effects. Ketones have even been linked to better brain function because they are a cleaner source of energy for your brain compared to glucose. Some people report sharper mental clarity and less brain fog during this stage. However, keep in in mind that not everyone reaches this stage, especially if your fasts are on the shorter side. The length of your fast will determine how far your body dives into ketosis, but once you're there, you'll probably feel a surprising clarity in both mind and body. And if you've paired fasting with a low-carb diet, you might hit this stage sooner than you expect. The longer you stay in this fat-burning state, the more efficient your body becomes at using fat for energy, which is why many people who practice intermittent fasting experience sustained weight loss. Ketosis is more than just a fat-burning phase. Studies suggest it may have other health benefits too, including better cardiovascular health, reduced inflammation, and even potential protective effects on your brain. People on ketogenic diets often report feeling more mentally sharp and energetic once they're deep into ketosis, thanks to the steady supply of ketones feeding the brain. Long-term fasting, the final frontier, but not for everyone. If you're a brave soul and keep fasting past 48 hours, you enter what's called the long-term fasting state, or the starvation state. But let's not get too dramatic here. Your insulin levels have dropped even further, and your body is pretty much running solely on ketones at this point. Gluconeogenesis kicks in, meaning your liver starts creating glucose from non-carb sources to keep your brain fueled. It's like your body going into survival mode, using whatever it can find to keep the most essential parts of you, your brain and heart, running smoothly. The shift to gluconeogenesis ensures that your brain has enough glucose to keep functioning, even if carbs are nowhere in sight. But this is where things can get dicey. Prolonged fasting, while it can be powerful, is also risky. Go too far, and your body starts breaking down muscle and could even damage organs. It's like driving with the gas light on. Sure, you can coast for a while, but eventually, you'll hit empty. This is why experts suggest that extended fasts should only be done with proper medical supervision. Your body can handle a lot, but even it has its limits. While long-term fasting can boost autophagy, your body's way of cleaning out damaged cells, it's important to balance the benefits with potential risks. Your body has a tipping point, and knowing where that is will keep you from crossing into dangerous territory. Muscle loss can start becoming a concern after 72 hours without food, and if the fast continues, your body may begin to break down proteins for fuel. This is why fasting for extended periods without medical supervision is risky. Sure, you're tapping into fat stores, but you're also putting your muscle mass at risk. The body prioritizes survival, but it can't sustain this forever. That's why long fasts are typically done under the guidance of health professionals, ensuring that you're not tipping into dangerous terrain. At the end of the day, fasting is like any tool. It can be incredibly effective, but only if you use it wisely. Fasting is more than just skipping meals. It's a process where your body taps into its resources, shifting from using carbs to relying on fat for energy. Your body is pretty brilliant, but it needs you to respect its boundaries. Fasting can be a game changer for your health, but just like with anything, moderation is key. So, whether you're fasting to shed some pounds, for health benefits, or just to see if you can, remember to listen to your body, take things step by step, and trust the process. Fasting should feel like a journey of self-discovery rather than a marathon of willpower. After all, it's not about perfection. It's about finding what works best for you and staying mindful of your health along the way.
Stay focused and stay fit.